is the inauguration bell. This is where they crowned all the kings of Ireland. So when Tiatefi came, she got married and crowned on this, over the Leofeld, the decoration stuff, Phallus Hall, here on this mound. On the 21st of June, 483 BC, which is why I've come today, because it's the anniversary of that happening. When she got here, that stone was here, and she had it removed because it's a phallic stone. And she had it taken to over by the left hand side of the mountain, and it was buried. In 1845, they found it. No, sorry, in 1839. It's on a map by, I think his name's George, his name's Petrie, P-E-T-R-I-E, and it's on a map of Tara, where they found it, and then they placed it here on the mound in 1845. We started the Irish famine because they had named it, and that sign there, Fathers had it taken down, and they were calling that phallic stone Jacob's pillar, God's throne on earth. So that was the greatest insult that they could make to God, to tell him to come and be sodomized sitting on a stone phallus. And the real Leofeld is in Scotland. It went from here, it went to Scotland, and then from Scotland it went to London, to England, and then in 1950 at 4 a.m. on Christmas morning it was repatriated to Scotland by four Scottish nationalists, and it's still there. They placed a fake stone copy on the high altar stone of Arbroath Abbey in Scotland on the 11th of April of 1951, and told the authorities, and it was removed on the 12th and taken to London, and it was a fake, and they knew it was a fake, and Elizabeth was crowned on it. They spent 15 months trying to find the real stone for her coronation, and they couldn't, so in the end they knowingly crowned her on a fake stone. So that stone is the curse of Ireland. And that's what caused the Irish famine. Yes, in 1845 till 1852, 7 years of famine.
That was the reason why it was seven, didn't it?
Exactly, yeah. You couldn't insult God more than calling that